Welcome back to the InfoHub training video series. In this video, we'll walk you through how to create a lease document in InfoHub. To start, locate the transaction for which you wish to create lease documents. To locate a transaction that requires a lease document, go to the Application Pipeline dashboard and click on the Approved Awaiting Documents tab. Then click the Go button next to the desired transaction. Or you can perform an application search and then click on the desired transaction number. You'll be taken to the application details page. Scroll down to the What Would You Like to Do Next section and click on the yellow Create Lease Documents button. You will be brought to the Create Documents screen. From the Program drop-down menu, select the appropriate program. Then from the Terms drop-down menu, select the appropriate term. Now, click the gray Next button in the lower right corner. You will be brought to the Billing Guarantor Information screen. Verify that the information listed for your guarantors is accurate, and then scroll to the bottom of the screen to click the Next button. You will then be brought to the Equipment Information screen. If you are a broker, you can click the drop-down menu to select a vendor office to associate with the lease agreement. Then enter your equipment description. Please include the quantity, manufacturer, model, and serial number of the equipment. Then select if the equipment is new, used, or reconditioned. When finished, click Next to proceed to the Processing Fee Information screen. This screen will let you determine who is responsible for paying the processing fee. Click Lessee to have the lessee customer make the payment, or click Dealer to pay the fee yourself. Click Next to proceed to the Method of Payment screen. At the Method of Payment screen, first select your customer's method of payment for the lease. If you select EFT Direct Payment, you will be asked to provide a bank routing number, an account number, and the name on the account. If you select Credit or Debit Card, you will be asked for the card type, the account number, and the card expiration date. If you select TBD, your customer will select their method of payment at signing. You will then be asked if time payment should automatically deduct the payable at signing amount. If you choose Yes, you will be asked to provide the customer's payment details. When finished, click Next. You will then be brought to the Summary page to review your documents before generating them. If you wish to make changes to a document section, click the Edit link in the lower right corner of that section. Once you verify that all the information is accurate and complete, scroll to the bottom of the screen and click the gray Populate button in the lower right corner to generate the documents. Once you click Populate, a PDF of your lease will download to your computer. If this transaction is eligible for ReadyDocs e-signature, you will see a check mark in the e-sign available box in the lower left. If you do not wish to use the ReadyDocs e-signature, you will need to send the PDF of the lease to the customer to sign. If you do wish to use the ReadyDocs e-signature for an eligible document, follow these few additional steps. Once you have clicked the Populate button and created your lease document, click the e-sign button that appears at the bottom of the application summary screen. This will bring you to the e-signature screen. Select the PDF document you just downloaded to your device by clicking the Choose File button. After you've selected the file, enter your customer's email address. If you have more than one signer, provide a unique email address for each signer. Once you've entered the email addresses, click the green e-sign button to send the documents to your signers for their electronic signature. When your signers receive the document, ReadyDocs will walk them through the steps to sign it electronically. Once all the signatures have been collected, the documents will automatically be sent to TimePayment for review. After you click the e-sign button, you will see a Document Has Been Sent for Signatures message at the bottom of the screen. Now that you know how to create a lease document in InfoHub, make sure you've watched the previous videos in our series on how to use InfoHub's powerful and user-friendly features.